Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. A warm welcome to all of you on this hot, bright and sunny morning. One of the agenda for today is to talk about this place. This place we are here at is B.V. Jagadish Science Center, National College, Jayanagar, Bengaluru. So, at this place, I see that there's a lot of crowd, and want to know more about this. This science center, I mean B.V. Jagadish Science Center, is built by this center is built by the National Education Society of Karnataka at a cost of 1.5 crores as a part of the college campus. My mind is detracting, a kind of wandering to know the reason why there's so much of crowd here. Is something hot happening here? Is some event happening here? We need to find that out. And let's find that out. We need to find a person who can give us some more details about this. I can spot Procheta there. He's my colleague. Let's talk to him and find more about it. Hi, Procheta.
Hi, hi. How are you, Lakshmi?
I'm doing great. He's my colleague, Dr. Procheta Malik, and he'll throw more light about this event happening here.
Yeah, it's a wonderful event. We've been working with Purna Pramiti now for 4 years, and every year we have an end-of-year exhibition. So today was a good event here at B.V. Jagadish Science Center in National College, Jayanagar. It's a public event. All the kids and their parents are here, as well as some guests. We had a nice guest lecture by a professor from Azim Premji University about telescopes and astronomical instruments that can be used or that are going to be built here in India itself and used by scientists here. So hopefully more children take all that up. And then coming here on the exhibition floors, as you can see, there's a lot of children presenting the work that they've done for the last year. A lot of nice, innovative, innovations from what they've been doing over the year, their own creations, their own experiments. So we are just walking around and enjoying that.
Looks great. So how many exhibits?
We have almost, with the 7th and 8th standard kids who are up here, about 20 to 25 exhibits. And I think downstairs with the junior kids, there's even more. So there's about 50 exhibits in all. And four of us are walking around and enjoying looking at that from ThinkTac. And of course, there are a bunch of parents and, teachers and so on who've come from Purna Pramiti who are enjoying the exhibition.
Okay, thank you so much, Procheta. Thank you. So, viewers, I'm on the tip of my toes now. I just want to watch all the exhibits. I'm curious to watch them. Are you also interested? If yes, then please follow me. Hi.
Hi.
What's your name?
My name is Dameshwari.
All right. So, this chart, it looks so colorful and a lot of glitter on it. So, what are you doing today?
I'm explaining the rusting of iron. So when water and oxygen, they have a chemical reaction with iron, they form a they oxidize and give out rust. So I have an experiment over here which I'm showing that oxygen and water both are needed to form rust. Here you can see there's only air or oxygen. So you can see there's no rust over here. But here there's only water and still you can see there's no rust. So here you can see there's a combination of both iron and oxygen. So you can see there's this reddish brown thing which is here on the nails, which is called rust. So you can prevent rusting by oiling it, greasing it, and the most accurate way is by galvanizing it. So galvanization is a process by which you put a layer of zinc on top of iron. So you can galvanize it and you can prevent it from rusting.
That was very nice. All the best. Thank you so much. What's this all about?
acids and bases and salts. Acids are the substances which have hydrogen ions and they're corrosive in nature. Corrosive is nothing but they're able to destroy things and they also have the ability to corrode metals. Depending on the amount of water present in acids.
I'm sorry to interrupt you. So you told me that acids, it has a tendency to corrode metals? All right, okay.
They can burn easily and depending on the amount of water present in acids, they can be either diluted or concentrated. Uses of acids are that sulfuric acid is used in industrial factories and it is also known as the king of chemicals and hydrochloric acid, which is present in our body, helps in digestion. It is a human phenomena that our skin, which is in our stomach, is adjusted to hydrochloric acid. But if we take out the hydrochloric acid from our body, it is very dangerous and it can burn out our skin.
Oh, it's that harmful, is it? I didn't know that we had hydrochloric acid in the stomach. Nice. All right, that was a lot of good information. Thank you so much. All the best. So viewers, you are watching ThinkTech Facebook Live to give you more updates about BV Jagdisha Science Center. ThinkTech is closely partnered with BV Jagdish Science Center. We are more privileged to work with them because we share a common goal of promoting science and innovation. And I'll keep you updated about the center, but let's, watch some more exhibits. Hi, what's your name?
My name is Mrudula.
So looks like there's some circuits here. Can you explain?
Yeah, sure. I can explain. This is about the conductivity in which the electricity passes through. So this is a circuit which I have connected to plus and minus, and I have an LED which is connected to cathode anode, and if we light, you can see the light.
Very nice.
Now I'll show this in which all the electricity passes through. I have a liquid here. This is orange juice, mainly citric acid. So let's try.
So it's orange juice.
Yeah, it's orange juice, and we can just find out if orange juice conducts electricity. We can see that orange juice conducts electricity.
And so. People, whatever you find at your home, maybe orange juice, and I can see that she's also kept lemon juice and tamarind juice, salt, water, all of that you find at home, you can, test if it conducts electricity or not, right? That's amazing. And I can also see some bangles kept there, some colorful bangles. I don't know for what reason. Let's check that out.
This is...
Oh, nice. She's conducting, checking if it's conducting electricity with bangles. Then I can say okay. Does it conduct?
Yeah, let us see.
Wow. The light glows.
Yeah.
Can I also check with some other jewelry? Any jewelry? I would like to test this. Let me check with my bangle. Let me check that. Can you check?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. So nice. Thank you so much.
Thanks.
That was very nice. All the best.
Thank you.
So viewers, to keep you more updated about BV Jagdish Science Center, ThinkTech, as I told you, it's closely partnered with Jagdish Science Center. And we are the custodians and curators of this place and the science museum at this place. So let's watch some more interesting exhibits. Can you see? It looks like a planet system here. This is one of the exhibits of the Science Museum, the Experiential Science Museum that's here. And as I told you, B.V. Jagdish Science Center, it promotes popular science, and it has an experiential science museum where it holds more than, I think, around 100 exhibits, interesting exhibits. If you come down to B.V. Jagdish Science Center, you'll get to know more about it. I can see some cups here, paper cups. I don't know what it is all about. Let's talk to the owner of this exhibit. Hi.
Hi, I'm Satvik. I'm going to talk about the anemometer and wind direction. So basically, the anemometer is basically a device for measuring the wind speed. In the anemometer, there are like two classifications. One is the pressure anemometer and the velocity one. The pressure one is used how much pressure is feeling on the anemometer, and the velocity one is like measuring the wind speed. So yes, like it is mostly in the weather stations.
Let me stop you here. I just, you know, had a doubt when you were like talking to me. It more looks like a wind turbine to me. So any difference between this wind turbine and this anemometer that you've made?
No, like this is just a model what I'm doing. Like if you go to a weather lab, it'll be more like updated, upgraded. This is the model. Like when we blow into it, it'll spin, right? So I just wanted to show that.
Okay, so it rotates and when the wind blows, and that's how it measures the wind, the speed of the wind. So what's the metric that you use to measure, because it rotates, right?
Meter per second.
All right, okay. I think that should be revolutions per minute or rotations per minute, I guess. All right, no problem. A good try and all the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
People, I think there are a lot more exhibits and something more upstairs. So we can also find parents here. Hello, ma'am.
Hello.
Your kid is studying here in Purnapramati?
Yes, he's in 7th standard. Okay. So they are displaying science experiments here.
Okay. Is he participating in the science exhibition?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so what is he doing and what's your feeling about this event happening today?
It is very nice to know that kids are getting exposed to various science experiments and how it is conducted, various science concepts. So he's doing one on anemometer, which measures wind speed.
All right, okay. Just now I spoke to him. I guess he's your son. Yeah. Spoke about anemometer. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Guys, let's move upward. Looks like there's some more exhibits. We should explore it. To tell you, to keep you more updated about Jagdisha Science Center, it's a public institution and it's open to public, anyone who's interested in science. And more established in the hope or with the hope so that the future generation, today's kids, can make the best use of it. Plans are already in place for the coming year. They've planned such that at least 5,000 kids from the nearby government schools are invited here to Jagdisha Science Center so that they enjoy and experience the science at Jagdisha Science Center. I think I lost my way. I'm just searching for the classrooms. Oh, there I see the crowd again. I'm sure, you know, something should be happening here. Hi. Okay, Museum 3. Oh, wow, there's a great crowd here. Lot of food stuff. I'm feeling hungry. Yes, of course.
So we're testing the food.
We are testing.
We are doing protein test.
Protein test. We want the chemicals.
To test protein. Now we are testing this potato. Can you see this?
We still had sodium hydrochloride or NaOH.
We want copper sulfate also. First we should put the potato, and after we should put the quantity of potato, sodium hydroxide, and we should put the copper sulfate drop to drop.
1 second is an option.
We should put the copper sulfate drop to drop.
Well, let's push this.
Yeah, we will put the copper sulfate.
Now
we will mix that.
So you can see that protein,
potato doesn't have protein,
but it contains starch.
Okay. This is egg's protein test. Egg has high protein in it, but milk has low protein.
So that's the reason there's some, you know, it's a dark purple and this is light purple. So what does it indicate if it's dark and if it's light?
The darker the color, the more the protein it contains. And do you know why this turns purple color when we add copper sulfate to it? Because, did you observe that first we add the NaOH? That separated the protein inside the food. Then we add that copper sulfate. In this copper sulfate, the copper reacted to the peptide bonds which are inside the protein. So when it reacts, it turns some chemical reaction and it turns purple.
All right, very well explained. And before I leave this exhibit here, I would like to give you a compliment for this group of people here. You look like a perfect set of researchers with that gloves on your hands. Thank you so much and all the best.
Thank you.
All right, let's move on. Looks like I can see some tissue paper, paper cups. What's this all about?
Seven cups is our experience name.
Seven cups, like seven swaras?
No. Not a sweet.
It's not a sweet, it's an experiment which we do.
Oh, seven sweets. Oh, the seven cups is the name of the sweet, right? With
You're
not doing that?
It is not a
merge of colors. It is you should put seven cups.
You should take seven cups, alternately put water and mix colors where you put water. And you are supposed to leave tissues like this. After some time, you get green color like that, we get everywhere. With cloth, we do the same thing, but it takes more time to absorb because it does not absorb as fast as tissue.
All right, looks colorful, very nice. More like a rainbow.
Last you will get white colors.
Okay. Thank you so much, very well explained. All the best.
Thank you.
Okay, let's move on. I can see judges. A tub with water. A small swimming pool. Hi, what's this all about?
It's a motorless boat. How much is it? It is pedal boat. How we swim like that, it does energy and pushes the water and it will move forward.
Tumba chanagide. Enadru hesri idiya nin boat ge?
ನೀರಿನ ತಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಮುಂದೆ ಯಾಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು
ಅದೇ ತರ ನೀವು ಇವಾಗ ಸ್ವಿಮ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಿರಲ್ಲ ಸೇಮ್ ಅದೇ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನೀರನ್ನ ಇದು ಹಿಂದಕ್ಕೆ ತಳ್ತಾ ಇದು ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ
ಏನಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ನೀರು ಹಿಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ನೀವು ಮುಂದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ ಯಾಕೆ
ಪುಷ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಾವು ಮುಂದೆ ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ
Guys, that was a good scenario of a discussion between parents and kids. let's move on. I can see some discussion happening here as well. Beam balance? I'm interested to know about this. Hi.
Hi.
So, can you explain more about this?
Our topic is beam balance. We are showing how to measure small things. For example, one duster is heavier than 5 chalks. And if we add 10 more chalks, the duster will be equal to 15 chalks. If you want to see here, there is some rice over here. We will measure it. 10 gram nut.
How many grams of rice? You're measuring it right now. Oh, okay, okay. So what's the weight of each of these nuts?
10 grams.
10 grams each, okay. All right.
10 gram.
10 grams.
20 grams. 30 grams. This rice is approximately 20 grams.
28 grams. Very nice. I would like to measure something.
Can you give something of yours?
Can I measure? Yes, I'm interested. Yes. They are checking the weight of my watch.
We put the watch. Grams. Grams. 10 grams. Grams. 20 grams. 30. This is 20.
Approximately 20 grams. My watch weighs 20 grams. Wow. Thank you so much. That was very nice of you. All the best.
Thank you.
Okay, let's move on. We can see some parents and kids having a nice, you know, discussion, science discussion. Let's talk to these kids here. Yen martidira ivattu nivo?
Naavu ivattu weighing machine anta martidivi.
Cardboard weighing machine. Okay.
Adralli bekagiruva things cardboard box, pencil, rubber band, glue, coins, matte, cardboard sheet, scissor.
Okay.
ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದೀವಿ ನಾವು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ವಿ ಒಬ್ಬರೊಬ್ರು ಹಂಚ್ಕೊಂಡಿದೀವಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಒಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನ ಹೇಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂ ಆಗ್ತಾರೆ
ಇದು ಹೇಗೆ ವರ್ಕ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಗ್ರಾಮು
15 ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ 15 ಗ್ರಾಮ್ಸ್ ಇವಾಗ 15 ಅಂತ ತೋರಿಸತ್ತಲ್ವ ನಾವು ಮಾರ್ಕ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ 15 ಅಂತ
ಸೊ ಇನ್ನೂ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಭಾರ ಇರೋದು ಹಾಕಿದ್ರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ
150 ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಅದು ವೇಯ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ 150 ಸೊ ಮಿನಿಮಮ್ 15 ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಹಾಕ್ತೀನಿ 30
ಓಕೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಭಾರ ಆದಾಗ ಅದಿನ್ನ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಬರ್ತದೆ ಸೊ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಕಾರ್ಡ್ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಮೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಅ ವೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ವಿತ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಕಾಸ್ಟ್ ಮೆಟೀರಿಯಲ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಸೈನ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಇನೋವೇಟಿವ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್
ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಡೈಲಿ ಲೈಫ್ ಟು
ಗುಡ್ ಇನೋವೇಷನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್
ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್
ಓಕೆ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ I can see some haldi, something yellow. It's not haldi. I think it's some leaves. Looks like a microscope. I would definitely want to see this. Or some colorful specks. Hi.
Hi.
What's this all about?
3D. What is 3D effect? How does it work?
Something like a 3D movie?
Yeah. Where is it? This is in 3D glass. It has right side it have a blue and left side it have red. And when you see this image, you'll get multiple colors which are moving. You'll get multiple colors. If you see this
you'll get multiple colors which are moving, because the
and brain does not know which color to see, and
your spectacles, when you close the blue lens and see it from red, you can see different shades. And if you close the red lens and see it from blue lens, you'll see different shades. When both eyes are also working together, the mind will get confused which image to show. That's why it will show both images together. Then the both images overlaps. Then it will look like 3D image.
Okay, so the perception of your mind is such that it thinks it's like, you know, it shows that it is moving.
Yeah. Okay. It will get confused what it should do. That's why it will merge both of the images. Then you'll get an overlapped images. Even a 3D movie also works like this.
Why? Because we will take red and blue, because in rainbow colors, first is red, so last is red, and the first is blue. It's first rose.
So some difference in the wavelength.
Yeah. Okay. The red and blue includes all colors. That's why with that we can see all shades of colors.
All right. Okay. Can I try that, please? Can I try? Oh, thank you so much. Will it fit me?
Multiple colors overlapping and moving, right?
Yeah, looks like something is like moving.
Yeah, that's the thing. That's the reason. In 3D image, 3D movie, you'll see that.
Now I see that it's 2D, but when I wear this, a perfect 3D. That was a perfect 3D image. And viewers, you are watching ThinkTech Live. Let's move on for more interesting exhibits. Okay, that was very nice. Very well explained. All the best. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you.
Some colorful balloons. And blowing the balloon. I can see some chart and some powder here. Looks like it's calcium oxide. Okay, let's give it to them. Let's let the owner talk about this. Hi.
Hi.
Your name?
Irvani.
So what's this all about?
Blowing the balloon acid and the base.
With you're doing something with an acid and a base and balloon. So what's this acid and what's this base?
Acid means which if we mix acid and base, it will the carbon dioxide will produce. So if we put some baking soda in the balloon and in the bottle.
So baking soda is acid. It's a base. Base, acid. I'm not aware of that. Okay.
So we need.
So guys, noted. The baking soda that you use for cooking, that's there in your kitchen, not in a pharmacy, that's there in your kitchen. It's a base. That's what the owner here tells.
And vinegar is acid.
Okay guys, so vinegar is an acid. Again, that's there in your kitchen. So she's using something that's there in your house, in your kitchen, some household materials, and doing some innovation. So let's check that out.
Now if we mix it, carbon dioxide will produce and the balloon will blow. We don't have the things to do. 1 second, we will do after.
You'll do it. You need some time for that. Okay, no worries. We'll get back to you. Can you do it? All right. We'll just go there and watch some more exhibits. And once you're ready, we'll get back to you. Okay? All right. So she was telling that she'll mix baking soda and vinegar, and with the help of those household materials, she'll do something with the balloon. She's still working on that. So let's get back to that. Meanwhile, we'll watch some more exhibits. Again, this looks colorful with some tissue paper, some tumblers, She's also having a set of felt pens there. It looks like oil. I'm not sure. Let's talk to the owners about this. Hi, guys.
Hi. I'm Anjana, 6th standard.
Hi, Anjana.
My name is Krishna. I'm studying 5th standard.
Alright.
I'm Chinmay and I'm studying in 6th standard.
Okay, looks so colorful, and you've written something on the KG cardboard. What's this about?
This is chromatography. Have you heard about chromatography anytime?
What's that? Chromatography. Is it something related to some digital colors or something related to colors? I know, but I'm really not aware of that. So you need to throw some light about it to me.
It's the mixture of colors. And it spreads out like this, tissue papers on the tissue papers. So my friend will tell the materials which we want now.
So I see that you've used tissue paper. So is it only tissue paper or any other paper that you can use, or even a cloth, or how does it actually work?
You can use in arts, drawing, paints, the color in one color, how many colors are there, you can see that. In only one color, you can see many colors. When the water comes top to the wick, and the water spreads out, and you can see the examples.
Okay, viewers, what he's trying to tell is, you know, you use just one color. Maybe say black. You color something like black or brown or something on the tissue paper, and then can you see this part here? She's added a wick over here. Can you see that there's a wick placed in water, and above it there's a tissue paper? Probably she's just marked one of the colors. I guess it should be brown color, but after some time, you know, the tissue paper that acts as a wick, it absorbs the water, and once the water rises, it further absorbs water, and the color that's there on this tissue paper starts spreading. So initially it was only brown, but now you see that there are combination of pigments in this brown color. Was it brown that was used?
Black.
Okay, she tells it was a black color that was used initially, but once it spreads, you can see that there's various pigments. I can see a slight combination of blue. I think it's a sort of a maroon and brown or red. So these combination of pigments make the color black. So do you see that, viewers? The color is not just a single color. It's a combination of pigments. So that was very nice chromatography. Nice name. All right. Thank you so much and all the best.
Thank you.
Okay. So the balloon activity, I'm still waiting for that. Meanwhile, let's check for some exhibits. I can see some exhibits of the Jagadisha Science Center. As earlier as I told you that it hosts an experiential museum where there are around 100 exhibits. So let's take a look at that. I can see a child playing with some coins. I'm not sure if it's something related to maths or science. Let's also check that. Hi.
Hi.
I see you're playing with coins. What's this all about?
We're doing coin to coin experiment.
Coin to coin experiment. Interesting.
We need 5 coins to this experiment.
What are you like up to? What are you going to do with these coins over here?
Experiment coin to coin. We need 5 coin to this experiment. We put
looks like kannada dalli heli putta
na coins na jodskobeku ಆಮೇಲೆ ಇನ್ನ ಒನ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್ ಇರುತ್ತಲ್ವಾ ಫೈವ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್
ಇವಾಗ ಕಾಯಿನ್ಸ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಏನಕ್ಕೆ ಕಾಯಿನ್ಸ್ ಅರೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ ವಾಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಸಿಗ್ನಿಫಿಕೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಏನಾದರೂ ಒಂದಕ್ಕೊಂದು ಹೊಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಏನಾದರೂ ಆ ಥರ ಏನಾದರೂ ಇದೆಯಾ ಹೇಗೆ ಆ ಶೇಪ್ಸ್ ಏನಾದರೂ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಾ
ಶೇಪ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಹೊಡ್ಕೊಳತ್ತೆ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾಯಿನ ಫೈವ್ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ಅಥವಾ ಸೆಂಟಿಮೀಟರ್ ದೂರ ಇಡಬೇಕು ಅದೇನಾಗುತ್ತಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಡೋಣ ಒಂದು ಕಾಯಿನ ಹೊಡಿಬೇಕು ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಕ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು
ಓ ದಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಸೋ ನೈಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ನ್ಯೂಟನ್ಸ್ ಕ್ರೇಡಲ್ ಶಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ನೋ ಕ್ಲಿಕ್ಡ್ ಶಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಪುಷ್ಡ್ ಒನ್ ಕಾಯಿನ್ and then one coin moves out if you push two coins moves out and that's the concept concept that's more related to force and I think it's more of doing with the Newton's cradle that was very nice very simple and more informative with simple stuff like coins that was very nice very sweet of you thank you so much
yes but my team ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಜನ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಟೀಮ್ ಅಕ್ಷೋಭಿ ಅಣ್ಣ ಅಲ್ಲಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವ್ರು ಕರ್ಕೊಂಬರಲ್ಲ
ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಪುಟ್ಟ ಆದರೂ ನನ್ನ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯಿತು ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಆಯಿತಾ ಆಲ್ ದ ಬೆಸ್ಟ್ ಓಕೆ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಮೂವ್ ಆನ್ ಐ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಸಮ್ ಏರ್ಪ್ಲೇನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಕ್ಸಿಬಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಯಂ the Jagdish the BVJ Jagdish Science Center exhibits I can see a child doing something with a magnet let's check with her for the details
6 centimeters per second and now we are doing with two magnets
takes more time or less time
Magnets will take more time as it's heavier, so as we love so. It is not rotating very well, but so now it's rotating. This takes 6 centimeter, 6 seconds and 4 centimeter per second, two magnets.
Why is it opposite? So if I take a heavy ball, let's say I take an iron ball.
There was a good discussion with the judges and the students there. I can spot another chief guest and he's a parent of Purna Pramati as well and he was a judge here. He's Professor Prateep Malik from Azim Premji University. Hi sir.
Hello.
So viewers, he's one of the chief guests. He's Professor Prateep Malik. Let's check with him for the views.
What do you want to know from me?
What's your feeling about this event?
It's very nice to see so many enthusiastic children and do all these experiments. Though a lot of the experiments are very similar to what we have seen before, but at least the enthusiasm of the children are there. So I think that's a nice thing.
Yeah, a lot of hard work I see with the colorful KG cardboard charts and a lot of work is being done. So you also judged, right? Were you a judge? So how did you feel? Was it too competitive?
No, I don't think it was competitive at all. I think the students are doing something that is totally their interest and they're trying to do it to the best of their ability. So I don't think it's... I didn't see any feeling of competition, which is nice, actually.
Right. All right, sir. Thank you so much. Okay. Guys, let's move on to the pending activity that we were supposed to see. An exhibit with, she was telling something to do with vinegar and baking soda.
We will do with lime and baking soda. Lime is also acid. So see how it reacts.
Oh, wow.
It's carbon dioxide is going up.
Produced and it's, the balloon is blown.
Okay, that's nice. So viewers... Do you see this? Nothing, you know, costly. Use a waste old bottle at home, a balloon that you use in your parties at home, and then some kitchen items like baking soda that you use for making idli batter or a dosa batter. And what else was that? Vinegar. You also use vinegar, right? So just mix vinegar and baking soda, add some water in the bottle along with those components, and then place a balloon over it, and you can see the balloon blowing by itself without you have to blow it. That was colorful and it was very informative. Thank you, owners. All right, thank you so much. All the best.
Thanks.
Okay, let's move on. Okay, we see some parents sitting here. Let's talk to one of the parents. Hello, sir.
Hello.
So, your kids are participating?
He's in 6th standard. He's participating there.
Okay, what's your opinion or what's your thoughts about this event that's happening here today?
Very nice event. I also enjoying that. Very nice.
So your old memories, school day memories should be like revived. Very nice, sir. So, hello, sir.
Yeah.
So, your son?
Not my son. So, my wife teaches. So, I just happened to see the experiments. So, quite interesting because of the practical aspects. And I think it also showcases, are they able to bring the theory to the practical? So, it's a lot of fun, basically. Yeah.
Okay. Very nice to hear that. Thank you so much, sir. All right, guys, let's move on. The event is going on. We can still see some parents coming in to watch the exhibits. I want to move down. So I just updated you about the BVJ Jagadish Science Center. Hi, students.
Hello.
So are you students of Purna Pramati?
Yeah, yes, we came here to watch all of them.
Yes. So you came here to watch your friends and support them?
Yes. Yeah, in our time we used to do this and we enjoyed this, and we can now see that they are also enjoying this.
All right, nice feeling. Okay, thank you for sharing that. All right, thank you. So I kept updating you about the BVJ Jagadisha Science Center. The director of this center, the BVJ Jagadisha Science Center, is Professor Natraj. In case we, spot him, we should also talk to him. We see some kids playing around. Oh, wow. There's another big crowd over here. I can see Suhail there. He's also my colleague. So, guys, you are still watching the exhibits. And I can see my colleague. A lot of interesting things happening here. I can spot my colleague there. His name is Suhail Ahanger. He's from ThinkTAC. And I would also like to share some thoughts about ThinkTAC and ISPF. So, hi, Suhail. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you? Hi, everyone.
Can you tell us something more about ISPF, ThinkTAC, and I know that we are also partnered with BVJ Jagadish Science Center, and we also facilitate Purna Pramati. So can you throw some more light about this?
So ISPF basically is the organization. It's an NGO. The name itself is Innovation and Science Promotion Foundation. So as you can, the word itself speaks innovation, which is you have idea and you create. That's innovation. So through it does help a child. What we do with the child is we try to make them be more innovative in terms of making their what they learn in school. So far, we're seeing in most of the world, if we talk particularly about India, it's mostly about in the classroom, there's a chalk and talk method, or we talk about theory most of the time. But hardly even the child, for example, a school child, he rarely gets a chance to do some practical experiments. So we people in college college or universities do some kind of experimentation.
So what you're trying to say is the teaching methods used in ThinkTac is very different from the chalk and talk method. It's more with to do with experiments. So experientially you learn something. That's what you're saying, right?
Right. So we say to a child, what do you want to become? He says the scientist. And then I ask the question, what is a scientist? He says, you do the experiments.
So how different could it be if a child learns through chalk and talk method, or if he learns through the experiments? Do you think that should be a difference or some good impact or something about that?
See, it's a common example I take whenever I want to talk about the experiential science learning, the importance of the experiments, is that a child, if I know everything about driving a car, I should have a handle, I should hold a handle, I should change the gears, and I know which side to take, when to honk, I know everything. But the first time I go into the car, I just stumble upon something, I don't know when to apply the brakes, I can hit anyone. Then I know, oh, there's importance, is like I have to experience it, then I will learn it more better way. The knowledge itself is a good food, but you need to make it, I guess, you need to know about which food to take when, or more about, if you talk more about the experiential science learning here now, so let's come back to what ISPF does in terms of experiential science learning, is we give child something, some world around them. So they have the world, which is the classroom, but there they're just getting the knowledge, getting the words inside their mind. But suppose that you're also getting the words for the driving a car, but when you go in the car, you learn. And then when we give a child that thing in them, rather instead of words, we give them something to play with. And when you give them that material they want to play with, they want to make what they have already got in their mind, they want to experience it, then they get to know what it is actually. So ISPF is actually promoting the way of experiential science learning in terms of doing it with the hands and experiencing it and understanding it, and then discussing with the teachers, all the facilitators which go. So ISPF does what it does, it provides the material as well as we have the people who educate the children, who facilitate. ISPF engages that with the it engages with the unprivileged children, but I guess the problem is about the learning experiential is throughout the school level for all the kids are the same basically.
But what's like, you know, I hear ISPF, ThinkTac, how are they both associated together?
So when ISPF was there after two years, so the people who founded the ISPF, we wanted to go out to reach the other children also, since ISPF being an NGO, to support it also we need some
funds, you need to raise it, okay,
to invest or some donation. So it was a great idea to come up with a private enterprise so that we can reach to the other private school children also, as well as we can support our NGO as well. But as of now, ISPF has been associated with the government school children, but through ThinkTac, we have reached far places throughout the India, and not even just going to the schools, but...
Throughout India, you mean different states? How many states do you reach them across?
So if I talk about ISPF, we are working with some government schools in Gujarat also. Of course, Karnataka as well as Chennai right now. Through ThinkTac, we have had partners outside the state of Karnataka in Chennai also, Mumbai. We have united people from Delhi. We have got some people who are tying up with us. So it's progressing at a good rate. Hopefully, we are actually planning with the dream is to reach out to the whole world and take the experiential learning to the whole world. But it's also through ThinkTac, we not only provide the kids with this facility to learn experientially, but we're also engaging teachers in this by having teacher training workshops to help teachers also to take the same experiential learning to the classroom where they teach, and then at the same time also teach while making also. So that way the ThinkTac is actually kind of upscaling the NGO as well as reach out faster to the broader area.
That was very informative, Suhail. We got a lot of details about that. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right. Guys, let's move on. That was very interesting. He spoke a lot about the learning methods that's being used. What he meant was when you learn experientially, when you do learn with experiments, it stays more in your memory than, you know, visually and verbally reading something. So that may not stay in your memory for a long time. And this is the right way of studying through experiments. And he also told about the teachers. So even they were, I mean, ThinkTech is training the teachers to inculcate this method of teaching through experiments so that, you know, the kids get the maximum benefit and understand and start liking science. Okay, looks like there are more colorful exhibits here. Banana peel, some plants, and look at this. So much of hard work being done. The small bits of cards with a lot of information. Let's speak to the owner of this exhibit. This looks really interesting and colorful. Lot of efforts behind that. So can you explain more about this? So what's your name?
My name is Tanmayi. So I have planned, if we are into gardening, we face these common plant diseases. For these common plant diseases, I have found some solutions. Like if you see these diseases, the solutions are like to spray fungicide, insecticide, pesticide. So for this, I have tried out five variations of insecticide, fungicide, and pesticides.
So how did you make it? You made your own fungicide and pesticide?
Yeah.
That's great. So how did you make it?
Yeah, so here are the things. Shall I explain the one recipe?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so these are the insecticides which I have made. This is one bulb of garlic with a small onion and pepper. You need to make a puree out of it and strain the mixture. For that, 1 teaspoon mild liquid soap.
Guys, viewers, are you listening? Did you listen to the materials being used? Again, it's all household materials. A bulb of onion and garlic, pepper and soap water. With all of these, she's made something very innovative. So people who are interested in gardening, look and watch this carefully.
So next is 1 cup of vegetable oil, mild liquid soap, and 1/4 cup of water. So mild liquid soap, I have used, I have just diluted herbal hand wash, which we use in our home. And so instead of vegetable oil, you can use 2 teaspoons of neem oil as well. And for the next one, 2 whole bulbs of cloves. We need to puree it with water and let the mixture sit overnight. And as optional, you can, for that mixture, you can add 1 cup of vegetable oil and 1 teaspoon mild liquid soap. So you can use it as a fertilizer. For the mixture you have got out of that, if we keep the ratio as 1:1/4, one is the mixture that you have got and 1/4 is the water which you are adding. And next is chop the tomato leaves. Chop the tomato leaves and then let it sit in the water for one whole night. Strain the mixture and use it as a spray. So next are the fungicides here. So you can use when fungus attack your plants. So one is, I have used skim milk. So to 1 part of skim milk, I have used like 9 to 8 parts of water. So that you can use. And cinnamon powder, you can just sprinkle it on the soil and mix it. And then black pepper. For black pepper, if your plant is like 7 inch long, for that plant, you need to like add 1/3 teaspoon of black pepper. And if you want to make a spray, you can be like for 1 liter of water, half liter of black pepper powder you can use. And 1.5 teaspoon of baking soda and 1 teaspoon of vegetable oil and 1 gallon of water plus dishwashing soap. You can use it as a spray as well. And the buttermilk, it's the best for fungicide for it. So 1 cup, 1 part of curd is to 2 parts of water. So you can use it like this. and these are the fertilizers if we come to take. You need to take 1/2 liter of milk, and for that you need to squeeze 1/2 lemon. So no heating, nothing is there. So you just keep the mixture overnight, and just you are like straining the mixture. The water you have got is this, and for this water, you need to add the normal water is 50:50 ratio. And for next one, I have soaked banana peels and orange peels with some jaggery. Instead of orange peels, you can use any peels of citrus fruits like mosambi and all that. So mainly jaggery helps for fermentation, and these all help for minerals, potassium as well.
So that's used as a mineral for the plant or a pesticide again?
Pesticides are the kind of same things. Okay, so you strain the mixture, the water you have got, you spray it as a fertilizer or thing, and the peels which are left behind with you, you can decompose those peels in the soil. And then 1 package of gelatin plus 1 cup of hot water and 3 cups of cold water. You can again use it as a thing. And then cocoa peat, the coconuts.
What's cocoa peat? Is it some soil or mineral or what is it?
Tengin naru.
Tengin naru jote cocoa peat maadirodu.
Tengin naru, you just need to decompose it in the soil, and then you can use it as a thing. And you can use your coffee grounds, banana peels, wet waste, Epsom salt, anything. And you can just put it in the soil. So if you just put it on top of the soil, it will become smelly. So what you do is mix the thing into the soil. And next, the last thing is 1 teaspoon white vinegar plus 1 gallon of water plus dishwashing soap. You need to use it in every 3 months. So this is the fertilizer. And for the strong things like pepper and cinnamon powder, you need to use it like 10 to 15 days, once in 10 to 15 days. Like that you need to use. And the other reasons for these plant diseases are inappropriate space between growing the plants, and over-watering or less watering and all that. So to spray these plants, I have made own spray. Can I show you?
Yeah, yes, please. She's made her own sprinkler. She's spoken about the minerals that can be used for the plants, the pesticides. She's also shown some plant samples here and efficient way of using water. So there she's using a sprinkler. Lot to learn.
Okay, so can you keep your hand like this? Okay, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I can, you know, feel some misty spray on my hand.
So this is just water. Instead of that, you can put these fertilizers and spray to the plant.
Okay, so that's a nice way of, she's found a device to use those pesticides. So you don't have to buy them. You can make it at home. And again, very simple materials being used. Just some straw piece and sellotape and some... Some foam piece to hold those straws. So she's told about gardening completely. I would hesitate to garden because, you know, I don't like to use those commercial chemicals. The smell of those chemicals, it irritates me. And I'm quite cautious about those things. So I tend to hesitate gardening because of that. But today what she's done is used all
which you can get in home, organic things, like which are not harmful for plants.
Yeah, that's right. It's not harmful. All these things are available at home. So the banana peel and whatever things that's available at home, you can use it for gardening. She's like shown complete concept about the gardening. So anyone who watches this should definitely start liking to, you know, garden. So they should start gardening after they watch this. So that was very nice, very informative. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, guys, let's move on. I can see some interesting exhibits. As I told you earlier, that BV Jagdish Science Center has a lot of science exhibits. Do you see a rocket there? Some satellites. I think that's a telescope that's there. A another satellite. Okay, that was very nice. A lot of nice exhibits. So if you're like really interested in watching all the exhibits, you can come down to Jayanagar to BV Jagdish Science Center and watch all of these science exhibits. As I told you, it's a public institution open to anyone who's interested in science. Now I think it's like almost, you know, time to end this Facebook Live show. And before I end, I would like to thank the chief guests. The chief guests for today was we spoke to Prateep Malik. He was one of the chief guests. He was from Azim Premji University, and also Professor Netraj, the director of this science institute, BV Jagdish Science Center. So my thanks to both of them, and also I extend my gratitude towards all these kids who have put so much of effort, so bubbly, so enthusiastic, the teachers who have trained them, the parents who would have also shown a lot of interest and guided their kids. And of course, the crowd that's gathered here, they are so interested, and that's a good encouragement for the kids. And I would also thank you viewers for watching this live show. Thank you so much, and have a nice day.